In my days in Elvina's, drinking with Clifford Makins and his friends, I was taught the importance of reading obituaries, especially when they are long obituaries written by friends of the deceased. And I was particularly enjoyed this, and was indeed enjoyed it even more later in life when I met Hugh Massingbird, who died last Christmas Day at a fairly young age, who was the obituaries editor of the Daily Telegraph. And he always said that, of course, the titillating, coded understatement of obituaries was the most amusing thing about them. And what I mean by that is that when you read in an obituary, I mean, you don't, if someone is a real four-letter man, you try not to say so, don't you, a couple of days after he died. I mean, it's a bit unfortunate. And I mean, when you read, "He did not suffer fools gladly," it means complete bastard. When you read "not over scrupulous in financial affairs," convicted fraudster. "A shadow hung over his later career," unconvicted fraudster. "Convivial companion," drunk. "Affable and hospitable at every hour," chronic alcoholic. "Fun-loving and flirtatious," nymphomaniac. "Keen eye for the ladies," flasher and rapist. And finally, "he was unmarried." "He was unmarried" can signify anything from, well, he was unmarried, to a lifetime spent cruising the underground public lavatories of the free world. My dear, I mean, talking for nearly an hour, we need to go and have a drink.